In this example problem, we calculate the molar solubility of a hydroxide salt in water, so we take into account the common ion effect. The problem reads, calculate the molar solubility of magnesium hydroxide in pure water. The solubility product constant of magnesium hydroxide is 2.06 times 10 to the negative 13. We'll start by creating a rise table for the dissolution of solid magnesium hydroxide in water. When one formula unit of magnesium hydroxide dissolves in water, it produces one magnesium ion and two hydroxide ions. We do not need to keep track of solid magnesium hydroxide in our rise table because solids are not in the equilibrium constant expression. Since we're dissolving magnesium hydroxide in pure water, we don't have any magnesium ions to begin with. However, pure water does have a hydroxide ion concentration of 10 to the negative 7th molar at 25 degrees Celsius. Since we don't have any magnesium ions to begin with, our reaction quotient Q will be zero, and will be shifting to the right to reach equilibrium. So our change in concentration will be plus x for magnesium and plus 2x for hydroxide, where x is the moles of solid magnesium hydroxide that dissolve in 1 liter of solution. This means x is also our molar solubility of magnesium hydroxide, which is what we're solving for in this problem. At equilibrium, our concentration of magnesium will be x, and our concentration of hydroxide will be 10 to the negative 7 plus 2x. For our equilibrium constant expression, the equilibrium constant equals the concentration of our products raised to the power of their coefficients divided by the concentration of our reactants raised to the power of their coefficients. Since our reactant is a solid, it does not show up in the equilibrium constant expression. Our solubility product constant expression is the concentration of magnesium ions times the concentration of hydroxide ions squared. We can substitute the KSP value given in the problem, 2.06 times 10 to the negative 13, as well as the equilibrium concentration row of our rise table into our KSP expression. To solve this, we'll need to make a simplifying assumption. We can either assume that 10 to the negative 7 is small compared to 2x, or that 2x is small compared to 10 to the negative 7. Let's start by assuming that 10 to the negative 7 is small compared to 2x. If this assumption is not valid, we can try the other assumption. If 10 to the negative 7 is small compared to 2x, then we can replace 10 to the negative 7 plus 2x with just 2x in our equilibrium constant expression. The right side of the equation simplifies to 4x cubed. To solve for x, we divide both sides by 4 and then take the result to the 1/3 power. Completing the calculation, x equals 2.06 times 10 to the negative 5th molar magnesium hydroxide. To check if this assumption is valid, our percent error should be less than 5%. To calculate percent error, we divide the part of the expression we removed by the original expression times 100%. We assume 10 to the negative 7 was small compared to 2x, so we remove 10 to the negative 7 from the expression. This goes in the numerator. The original expression is 10 to the negative 7 plus 2x, so this goes in the denominator. If we substitute in the value of x that we calculated based on our assumption and complete the calculation, we get 0.134% error. This means our assumption was valid, so our molar solubility is 3.72 times 10 to the negative 5 moles of magnesium hydroxide per liter of solution.